In today's video, we're going to be industrializing our small furnaces. First of all, you're going to need a number of small furnaces. I'm just going to place these on the back wall here, but they could actually be located anywhere in your base that you can reach with industrial pipes. You're going to need two storage boxes. Just going to place one at either end. You're going to need a button and an igniter. And I'm just going to put the button here. And the igniter can go in front of the middle furnace. You're going to need five storage adapters and two conveyors. Storage adapters can go on the boxes and the furnaces. And the conveyors can go either side of the furnaces. So I'm going to connect up the first box to the first conveyor. I'm going to connect the furnaces and the conveyors together. And we're going to connect the second conveyor to our second box. I'm going to change the filters. So for the first filter, we're going to need wood and something to cook, in this case, sulfur ore. I'm just going to set the max on both of these to 50. And for the filter mode, we need to do require all. On the second conveyor, we're going to set this to charcoal and sulfur. And we're not going to change the filter mode. In terms of wiring, we're going to take your power source, which in this case is a small rechargeable battery. Going to send power to the first conveyor, and then from the pass through we're going to send power to the second conveyor. Now we can turn these on. Lastly, we're going to take the output from the button and connect it to the igniter. So the reason for the button is that this is a semi-automated method of running your furnaces. You can put your wood and ore into this box, and then when you're ready or feel safe enough, you can hit the button and start your smelting. The ore and the wood will be used up automatically from this box. These will get filled up to 50 of each on each tick, and your sulfur and charcoal will end up in the box at the end. With a few small changes, you can use these furnaces to smelt high quality metal or metal fragments, but obviously here I've shown you the most important thing, which is smelting sulfur. If you like this video, then feel free to give it a like, and if you want to see more content like this, hit subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.